Your rep, Jack. Your rep. Your rep. Come on, come on.
Giles Thomas from MuscularDevelopment.com here. I'm here with new junior British champion, UKBFF British champion, Jack Stokle. Jack, congratulations, mate. How do you feel?
Words can't describe how I feel right now. A dream come true. No words can describe how I feel. I had a dream for 3 years and I never thought it would become a reality. So for it to become a reality is indescribable. Best feeling in the world.
Surely it must be even be a bigger sort of a joy for you that the fact that they moved the UKBFF, changed the age of the junior to under 23. Now you've just said you just turned 21 2 weeks ago, so that means really, you know, you beat guys there who arguably got 2 years on you.
Yeah, it feels more of an honour, to be honest, and I feel quite proud knowing that hard work's paid off. I was 21 5 days before the British, so I started.
You're like 20.
Yeah, so literally, basically 20 when I won. Started depleting on my 21st birthday, which was a world of fun. but yeah, I feel really proud that I did it at a young age, you know. I watch people like Flex Lewis, they all did it at a young age. So if I am looking to replicate their success, it's a good sign.
Theoretically, you could conceivably win the British chart finals another 2 years on the trot.
Theoretically, yes, but in practice, no. I've ticked that box. That was a dream, that was a goal. I've accomplished that. So I don't really know what my plans are as yet.
You don't want to defend your title next year?
No. I would see that as staying the same or going backwards.
Okay, so what if the UKBFF Bill Turney asked you to, say, do the World Championships or an international IFBB show?
Then I'd be on a diet.
You'd be on a diet?
Then I would be on a diet. That's a different question, because that's progressing. I always see bodybuilding about progressing, becoming better as an individual. As a person, but also as a bodybuilder, I would see doing the British juniors as staying the same, and I want to become better and better, and I want to be a big fish in a big pond, so I've got to keep pushing myself. I know that if I'm competing against some of those super heavies, I've got to train hard and I've got to eat.
What would say your height and your weight on stage?
I'm 6'2" and I was 15 stone, 4 pound.
So that's 214.
Yeah, it's 214 at 20. And condition-wise, I maybe could have been a touch, maybe two pound lighter. But
really, your condition was good, mate.
Maybe the glutes were in, but I would have liked them really in. But I think to do that, I might have had to risk losing a little bit too much muscle tissue. Now, I'm not one of those people that goes, "Oh, I've got to keep my size." But it is bodybuilding. It's not skinny guys on stage. So I think I found the right balance on the day in terms of condition versus size. So, but yeah, that's how I say, 6'2" at 214.
So here at Gold Star Gym, which arguably is one of the best gyms, maybe not just in the northeast of England, obviously Newcastle, but probably in the country. Now this is a gym I've actually trained at on and off since 1997. Now I've been hearing about you from another top, bodybuilding champion, junior, novice, you're like Steve Baker. Now Steve's been going on about you for the last couple of years, but I always seem to miss you when I was training. I think we must have trained at different times. You know, it's finally good to, it was finally good to first see you on stage, you know, so.
Well, it's a pleasure, Giles. Thank you, Muscular Development, for coming down and seeing me. But yeah, Steve's been there and done it. So if you are going to listen to someone, Steve, for me, was the man. He has the same similar approach to myself. We don't do anything stupid. We keep it simple. If you're only doing 5 things, only 5 things can go wrong. If you're doing 20 things, it's like, man, what am I going to change? What's going right and what's working for me and what's not? In terms of the prep this year, I wouldn't say Steve was my prep man, but he was a good help. I made the final call, but I have someone like him there just to question even little things like, Steve, what do you think about my cardio in that last week? Little things like that. What are my legs looking like? Are they a little watery? Are they a little bit inflamed? Should I hold back on the cardio? Someone to reassure you.
Steve actually, my ears pricked up when he said, "Oh, you'll win the British," like just like that. Now Steve's someone I know that doesn't talk shit. He doesn't just talk at his ass. And when he said that, I said, "Really?" He says, "Oh yeah, if he goes to the NABBA Worlds, well, the universe, he'll probably win that as well." And I thought, wow, I've really got to get a look at this guy.
It's funny you say that because you'll never see it in my face. Everyone will say, "Oh, Steve's complimented you," and I'll go, "Has he?"
he was absolutely certain. Now some people, when they say, "Oh, my guy can win," da, 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 you're like, "Yeah, whatever."
No, Steve's no bullshit. If anyone that knows Steve as well, they know he's down the line. But that's what I need.
Set 3 or 4. First 2 and only 12. Give or take failure, about 90%. Third set, we generally do a drop set like that. Increasing time under tension. You may have failed with two plates and a 5, but you still keep on going and going and going. Don't do that stretch, squeeze. Throw your neck, but a lot higher rep range. We just found what works for us. And then our fourth set, we do something called rest pause. So we'll probably put 2 plates on. We get as many as we can, we'll rack it. 4 or 5 big deep breaths. Go for as many as we can, we'll rack it. 4 or 5 deep breaths, go for as many as we can, and we'll rack it. 2 plates, let's go.
What about that guy you can, the guy took second to, the 2009 UKBFF British champion, James Hollingshead? What was it like competing against a guy that big and that hard and beating him?
To be honest,
it's one big lump.
He's a big guy, you know. He probably had an 87 pound on me on the day. Just looking, I don't know what he weighed in at, but looking at him. But I've never been one. I didn't know who he was until the day of the show. Until someone said, "Oh, by the way, that's the 09 winner." All I could do was concentrate on me. If I was the best I could be, then I've done my job. But when I seen him backstage, man, my heart started going.
He's big.
This guy's big. And obviously when you look at yourself, your bicep may be that thick, but you see it as that thick. So my bicep went from being that thick to that thick.
Body dysmorphia on the day of a show, eh? You know?
Yeah, psychological issues were going crazy when I seen him strip off backstage, you know. But that lineup was fantastic. If any look at the pictures, guys.
They're all on MD. Yes. Go to the show gallery.
Yep, go to the show galleries, look it on the MD website. That